is the ones place, this is the tens place, and this is the hundreds place. So ones place, tens place, hundreds place. Now, when I want to go from ones place to tens place, I need to multiply by 10. Now, once again, if I want to go from tens place to hundreds place, I need to multiply by 10 again. So, as I move to the left, it becomes 10 times bigger. So, the digits, they represent 10 times bigger numbers, or the place value becomes 10 times bigger as I move to the left. Now, what happens if I move to the right? So, if I divide by 10, I can come from hundreds to tens place. Once again, if I want to go from tens place to ones place, I need to divide by 10. So, as I'm moving towards the right, the digits are becoming 10 times smaller. So it becomes 10 times smaller. Now what happens if I move further to the right? That is, if I move to the right of ones place. So once again, if I divide by 10, now what is 1 divided by 10? 1 divided by 10 is 1 by 10. So if I move further to the right, I will get 1/10 place. So this is ones place, this is tens place, this is hundreds place. But if I move to the right of ones place, I get 1/10 place. So let us understand this with the help of a number. So if this is a number, 423, it represents 4 hundreds, 2 tens, and 3 ones. So this 3, suppose, represents 3 cookies, 3 single cookies. 2 tens represents 2 blocks of 10 cookies. So 2 tens represents 2 blocks of 10 cookies, and 4 hundreds represents 4 blocks of 100 cookies. So this is the meaning of this number, 423, 4 hundreds, 2 tens, and 3 ones. Now, what if I divide this cookie into 10 parts? So right now, what I was doing was clubbing the cookies. So this one cookie was clubbed into groups of 10. This group of 10 was further clubbed into a group of 10 to form hundreds. But now, instead of grouping them, what if I divide this single cookie into 10 equal parts? Let us see what happens. So this is a single cookie, and I divide it into 10 equal parts. So I get 10 equal parts, and each part. So this is 1 out of 10 equal parts. 1 out of 10 equal parts is represented by 1 by 10. We know, we have learned this in fractions. 1 out of 10 equal parts is represented by 1 by 10. So this is 1/10, and this represents 1/110. So it is 1 out of 10 equal parts. So 1/10 place is represented by 1/10 of a single cookie. So this means that if I divide 1 into 10 equal parts, I get 1/10, which is represented by this number. So this is 1/110. Now, between 420 and 430, there are 10 divisions. So, if I divide 420 and 430 into 10 equal parts, I can represent these numbers. Now, what if I take this part? That is the part between 423 and 424. and further divide it into 10 equal parts. So I take 423 and 424, I elongate it and I further divide it into 10 equal parts. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 equal parts and each part would represent 1 by 10. So this is 1 by 10, 1 out of 10 equal parts. So this number is actually 423 1 by 10 because 423 plus 1 by 10 gives me 423 1 by 10. And now I know that 1 tenth place comes after the ones place. So I can write a 1 here for 1 1-tenth. So this is 1 1-tenth. So how do I represent this number? So 4, 2, 3, 1. But if I write this number in this way, then is 1 the 1 place? Or is 1 in the 1-tenth place? So what does 1 actually stand for? So in order to resolve this confusion, what we do is I put a dot. I put a dot after the ones place. This dot is called the decimal point. So this dot is called the decimal point and we put this dot after the ones place to show that this is actually the tenths place. We call it tenths place and I represent it using a small t. So just like I use O for ones, T for tens and H for hundreds, I use a small t for tenths place. It is actually 1-tenth place, but I call it tenths place and I represent it with a small t. How do I read it? I read it as 423.1. 423.1. So this is the tenths place. And this number is actually 4 into 100 plus 2 into 10 plus 3 into 1 plus 1 into 1-tenth. Now what if I take two divisions? Then I have 2 out of 10 equal parts. So this is actually 2 into 1 by 10. So 1-tenth place will have 2, or the tenths place will have 2. So I can represent it using 2 here. So this is 2 into 1 by 10. 2 into 1 by 10. If I consider 3 out of 10 equal parts, then I denote it by writing 3 in the tenths place. This is actually 3 into 1 by 10. So similarly, I can represent any of these divisions or any of these parts using a decimal point. So suppose if I want to represent this 6 by 10, then I simply put a decimal point and write 6 in the tenths place. And this is how I can go on to 7 by 10, 8 by 10, 9 by 10. And what happens after 9 by 10? After 9 by 10, we have 10 by 10, which is equal to 1. And 423 plus 1 gives me 424. So just like after 9, I move to the left, place value to the left here. Similarly, over here also, after 9, I move to the left. So after 423.9, I'll make it 424. That is, this becomes 0 and the next digit increases. So the number becomes 424. And this is how I can represent it. So 1 by 10 by 0.1, 2 by 10 by 0.2, 3 by 10 by 0.3 and so on. And this is how I can write the different numbers. 423.1, 423.2, 423.3 and so on. And after 423.9, after 423.9, 9 becomes 0 and 3 becomes 4 to give me 424. So remember, 424 can also be written as 424.0. It is the same thing. So if we have any number, we can put a decimal point and a zero after that. It remains the same thing. So this is what I mean by decimal point. A decimal point is put after the ones place to represent digits or places which are less than one, that is the tens place. So this is the tens place and it represents 1 by 10. If you like this video, then subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all the learning resources as per CBSE, ICSE, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures on Maths, Science, English and Social Science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve the slightest of your doubts. And that's not all. You can also win exciting prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at deltastep.com, learning is not just fun and easy, it is rewarding too. So register for free now.